2 years ago, Tetsuya Takahashi and Monolith Soft, the company behind the Xenoblade franchise, Takahashi was also the creator of Xenogears, put out a recruitment message on their website. And for the most part, it was pretty standard fare. He was talking about how Monolith had not laid off a bunch of people, but that the company, as a whole, has a much smaller staff than what is typical for developers that are building RPGs at the scale that Monolith is doing. But the interesting thing that he said, something that I thought was a little bit spicy, that might get some people really maybe talking about this a bit more, was that a game's maps are the vital point of an RPG. It is not, I think he says, it is by no means something like the story. He goes on to say, without well-made maps, the game won't stand on its own. On the other hand, though, they allow everything else to fall into place with relative ease. Based on experience, I can make that kind of statement with certainty, and everybody else at Monolith Soft feels the same way. Even just being involved in that area of the game's creation is both extremely important and rewarding. So I remember reading that, and it really started making me think about RPGs. Now, the point of this video is not to, like, debate Tetsuya Takahashi over this, or even to make any kind of definitive statement about what is the vital point of an RPG. I think a lot of people are going to have a different answer to that. But as I've thought about it, if there is a vital point to an RPG, I think that that vital point is right there in the name of the genre. RPG, role-playing, essentially character progression. Character progression, to me, is the vital point of an RPG. It's like a defining element of what makes an RPG. And in my opinion, if the developer's goal, when they set out to make a game, is to make a great RPG, I think that that should probably be the place where they start, is how are we going to give the player the sense that they are growing with this character, right? That they're making choices about how to develop this character into the class or the role, or even in some character progression systems, a master of everything. How are we going to make that process interesting? How are we going to allow the player to feel like they are building that character into who that player wants them to be? I think that above all, if your goal is to set out to make a great RPG, should be probably where you start. Now, this isn't to say that you can't have a really great RPG that has suboptimal character progression. I love Chrono Trigger. It is my favorite game of all time. But the reason I'm drawn to that game are for other elements outside of the role-playing aspects, of which there are very few. The game is actually very linear. It's very story-focused. And so things like the graphics, the music, the characters, and the story are what captured me about Chrono Trigger, much more so than the role-playing elements, which are very straightforward and vanilla. It's fairly bare bones, is what I'm trying to say. Yet still, I consider it a great RPG. So what I'm saying here is not to say that that the role-playing elements, the character progression, is the only vital element of an RPG. Obviously, you know, exploration and map creation, as Tetsuya Takahashi is saying here, are also very important. And combat is very important. And, you know, music is very important. And storytelling is very important. It's all important. But to say, if we're going to pick one thing to be the vital element of a genre, RPGs, to me it makes more sense to say that the defining element of that genre is probably the vital element of the game. This goes back to the genesis of RPGs as we know them today, D&D, tabletop role-playing. The draw to role-playing games like that is to customize your character and grow that character over time. And the fact that people will sometimes play the same character for multiple years and through multiple campaigns, right, speaks to the attachment that you get to building that character. And with every level up, you sit there and you deliberate how you're going to spend your points into skills and how you're going to, in the long term, grow this character into the character you want them to be. That is at the center of what makes RPGs appealing. I kind of came to some of these conclusions while I was playing Fire Emblem Three Houses last year. And I haven't talked about that game much on the channel. It was a game that I really enjoyed. So I found myself playing this game for over 150 hours, and I'm not even done yet, right? Like I've only really completed one of the campaigns, the Blue Lions story, but I haven't done the Golden Deer, and I'm only halfway through the other ones. But yet I had played this game for 150 hours, and that's very rare for me. I very rarely play a game for longer than 40 hours. Generally, when I see superfluous content, when I see busy work, when I see side content that doesn't feel very relevant to sort of the core experience of the game, or that when quests don't tell great stories in their own right, but just kind of turn into fetch quests and errands for the player to run, I tend to start checking out at that point. To me, those types of things feel like padding, and I know I'm in the minority to some degree on this, but I tend to wish that they would just cut that, rather than padding the game and then, you know, being able to, in their marketing, say, oh, we have over 50 plus hours of content in this, or 100 plus hours of content, when most of that amounts to grindy, busy work, right? I tend to not enjoy that, but for some reason, I was playing Fire Emblem Three Houses and enjoying that kind of thing. The exact kind of thing that I was not into, or typically am not into, like just grinding through battles over and over again, or, you know, going and talking to every single character and doing all of the little side quests that they ask for. These types of things, usually I will skip, but in Fire Emblem Three Houses, I was doing them willingly. And I was trying to think about why that is, and I realized it was because the character progression of Fire Emblem Three Houses is what I was hooked into. I was so hooked into the class system, into taking characters and seeing where they were weak, seeing the specific areas, whether it was with certain weapons or certain types of magic or with whatever it might be, their stats, and saying, I'm going to switch their class into something that will require them to get better at those weaknesses. I just really got into growing the characters to where they were really efficient in all areas, and I could use them however I wanted to in the battles. That process of taking character weaknesses, turning them into strengths, and taking a character who might have been designed to be this type of class, but saying, no, I want to turn them into this type of class, was a really fun process for me. I really enjoyed that. As long as that element is strong in an RPG, where the player feels like they have the ability and the choices to take their character and turn them into whoever they want them to be, that, for the most part, I think, is what makes an RPG great, is whether or not that process is really fun or engaging or interesting, or whether that hooks the player into the gameplay loop. This is by no means meant to be some sort of, like, refutation of what Tetsuya Takahashi is trying to say or what he's learned over his decades of experience in the industry. It's more just, you know, sort of these thoughts that I've had over the years, and especially since reading this quote, that I wanted to share and sort of like get other people's opinions on, because I think it's kind of an interesting topic. Like, what makes an RPG an RPG? And what is the most important element of an RPG in that case? For me, I think it's the role-playing elements. I think it's what's right there in the title. And I think that boils down to character progression. All of those other aspects, whether it be exploration, whether it be combat, whether it be the story, those are things that apply to basically any genre there is. If you have a great story or a great combat system in mind, right, you could then still, if you built your game around that, still turn it into pretty much whatever genre you wanted it to be. But if you want your game to be an RPG, then it is vital that you have role-playing elements, that you have character progression and a means of customizing that for the player so that the player can build the character they want to play. If it doesn't have that, it's not an RPG, and you could turn it into something else entirely if you wanted to. So to me, that's the reason why I identify that as the most vital element of an RPG. But let me know what you think. Go ahead and leave me a comment. I will be reading them today when I post the video for sure. And I want to see what other people, you know, come up with or if there are any strong counterpoints to this. So I appreciate everybody watching. I will see you again soon with a new video. Still working really hard behind the scenes on the Final Fantasy Retrospective series. And until next time, have a great day.